Hello students. So in the previous class we have studied about relative extremum thing, what is relative extrema, what is relative maxima, what is relative minima, and also we have studied the theorem related to that. Today we will study about what are critical numbers. So critical numbers are nothing but a function f is said to have a function f is said to have critical number c, such when we can say that it is a critical number if f dash of c is equal to 0 or f dash of c does not exist at that point c, then we say that the c is the critical point. So remember, c should be in the domain of the function f. So I'll go with a few examples for this. So find the critical number of f of x is equal to x to the power 4 by 3 plus 4 into x to the power 1 by 3. So you know that I said f dash of c is equal to 0 or f dash of c does not exist. So clearly we have to find the derivative of this. So we'll find the derivative. F dash of x is nothing but 4 by 3 into x to the power 4 by 3 minus 1 plus 4 into 1 by 3 into x to the power 1 by 3 minus 1. So when we simplify, we'll get 4 by 3 into x to the power 1 by 3 plus 4 by 3 into x to the power minus 2 by 3. You can observe that 4 by 3 is common in both the things. So we can take it outside, 4 by 3. So we'll get x to the power 1 by 3 plus 1 by x to the power 2 by 3. So we are going to the LCM method. So we will get that as 4 by 3 into denominator, I'll take it as x. So I'll get, x to the power 2 by 3. So I'll get in the numerator as x plus 1. So here two things are possible. That is, either f dash of x is equal to 0 or f dash of x does not exist. So when f dash of x, if I consider it as 0, I'll get this as 4 by 3 into x plus 1 divided by x to the power 2 by 3 is equal to 0. So this x is defined for, this function is defined for all the values of x in the domain of f. So I'll get this as x plus 1 is equal to 0. This is nothing but x is equal to minus 1. So clearly one critical point we have obtained, that is nothing but x is equal to minus 1. Now we have to find one more critical point, that is when the function, that derivative of the function does not exist. So f dash of x does not exist. So I'll take this as f of f dash of x is equal to 0, or you can also represent this as nr is equal to 0 or this as dr is equal to 0. So when the function value does not exist, that is nothing but when x to the power 2 by 3 is equal to 0, that is nothing but x is equal to 0. So here we obtain two critical points, that is minus 1 and 0. These two are the critical points of f of x is equal to x to the power 4 by 3 plus 4 into x to the power 2 by 3. We'll consider one more example. F of x is equal to x minus 3 divided by x plus 7. So as I have explained in the previous problem, first we have to find what is f dash of x. So f dash of x is nothing but, you know that we have to use here the quotient rule. So we'll get x plus 7 the whole square into x plus 7. Here the derivative is nothing but 1 minus 0 minus x plus 3 into 1 plus 0. So we'll obtain x plus 7 minus x minus 3. So here minus, so here plus, divided by x plus 7 the whole square. When I simplify this, I'll get it as x will get cancelled. So 7 plus 3 is nothing but 10 by x plus 7 the whole square. So here the function f is defined only for, defined for all the points in the real value system, but as such for minus 7. So, I can consider the domain as x r minus set containing minus 7. So, we will find what are the critical points now. So, f dash of x is equal to 0 or nr is equal to 0. So, what will happen is, we will get, when we solve, we will get 10 is equal to 0, which is not possible, which is absurd. So, this is not the critical point of this function f of x. So, one more thing is there, that is f dash of x does not exist, that is dr is equal to 0, that is x plus 7 whole square is equal to 0, that is x plus 7 is equal to 0 or x is equal to minus 7. But this minus 7 does not belong to the domain of the function f, because we have defined the domain of the function f as r minus set containing minus 7. So, this does not belong to domain of f. So, this function doesn't have the critical point. So, we have understood that what are critical points. Critical points are nothing but the points where the function f dash of x is equal to 0 or where the function f dash of x does not exist. So, I can move to the further example, one more problem, that is f of x is equal to x cube plus 7x square minus 5x. So, we have to find f dash of x. F dash of x is nothing but 3x square plus 14x minus 5. Now, you can observe that we have obtained a quadratic equation here. Now, there are two cases. One is f dash of x is equal to 0 or f dash of x does not exist. But clearly here f dash of x does not exist condition doesn't arise. So, we can leave that thing. So, we are considering only one thing, that is f dash of x is equal to 0. What is f dash of x? That is nothing but 3x square plus 14x minus 5 is equal to 0. You know how to solve the quadratic equation. So, that is nothing but we have to get 15 minus 15 and we have to get as 14. When I solve that, I will get 3x minus 1 into x plus 5 is equal to 0. So, here there are two cases possible, either 3x minus 1 is equal to 0 or x plus 5 is equal to 0. If I take 3x minus 1 is equal to 0, I will get x is equal to 1 by 3. If I take x plus 5 is equal to 0, I will get x is equal to minus 5. So, x is equal to 1 by 3 and x is equal to minus 5 are the critical points of this function. So, critical points, how to find it? I hope you have understood. Thank you, students.